and you have to go in over here, multi tools for Facebook once again, right? Once you enable this tool, like once you log in and go into the tool, this tool will be enabled. Okay. Now over here, there is something very unique in this tool called as tools. Okay. Yeah, you can easily manage your friend request, friends remover, pages scanner and all. But what you could do is, if I just go over here, pages scanner. Okay. Yeah, this is what is something known as page scanner. Okay. And now what I can do using this is I can take up any FB profile. Okay. And it's user ID. Okay. For example, let me go on to my Facebook and I'll choose, let me just choose anyone. For example, this guy over here. Right. And what I can do over here is one of my college friend basically. Okay. What I can do as of now, I can just copy this URL. You can see I'm getting an ID over here, right? This is nothing but the Facebook user ID. In many profiles, you don't get. What you can do is you can go online. Find your Facebook ID, find my FB ID. Okay. Again, if I'll go on that particular page, choose any profile, actually you can choose any profile. Okay, let me be random and choose any profile over here. Again, I'm getting an ID. At times you don't get an ID over here. You can copy that entire URL, paste over here, and you can just click over here and okay. Basically, this is the Facebook ID itself, right? And many a times you don't get it. Many times you don't get it. Okay. So here is the Facebook ID. You can copy this ID, paste it over here, and click on search. Okay. What basically will happen is, you'll be able to see the liked pages of the person. Also, there is one more important tool over here. I think it's interaction scanner. Just give me a minute. What page they have liked? I think they have removed this feature. I'm not sure. Just give me a minute. Let me just check. I hope that feature isn't removed. Okay, just give me a minute. Yeah, actually they have removed that tool, I guess. Yeah, sorry folks, I didn't check, it's my bad, I didn't check. There was something over here called as group scanner, okay, in this particular tool itself, okay, but now it is removed. I don't know why. Yeah, it is removed, I guess. Okay. What used to happen in this page basically is, in this there was a feature called as, yeah, see, group scanner, I think. Yeah, I didn't saw this. Yeah, so there was some 4 days ago it is removed. Okay, I hope it will be back once the developer will find a fix. There was a tool called over here called as group scanner, and what it used to do is it used to tell that which of like that particular profile is in which Facebook groups, in what role, whether he's a member, he's an admin or something. Unfortunately, I cannot do that as anymore. I didn't know that this particular feature has been removed, but like keep this tool in mind, because this is the updated tool. The developer keeps on updating over here. You can see the change log 4 days ago. If there is a fix found, okay, if there is a fix found for this, right? So yeah, it will, the developer will bring an update for 110%, right? Saying that there will be an option for group scanner, and it will tell you the groups in which any Facebook profile is. You can just enter the groups then, and you can see their interactions and view them. Right? Now, another important aspect in terms of OSINT, and which is known as Multigo, and this is a tool basically. Available for Linux, Windows, Mac. Trust me, if I talk about Multigo, we can even have 15-20 days, you know, separate thing on it. It's so deep, right? But ignoring those all things, because many of the things in Multigo does also require some premium access. Okay. Now, this is how the Multigo looks like initially. And these are nothing but Multigo transforms. The very first page that you see, they are nothing but Multigo transforms. Now, there are by default transforms that are already available, and some of them you can even add separately, right? So what I could do is I can go and fetch over here like all types of transforms. See the categories, right? And useful for teams, cyber crime over here, cyber and digital forensics, fraud investigations. These are some of the areas. But you can see there are a lot of transforms. Maximum of them are actually paid, because they require API, which in case if we have that premium service, then only we can add, right? But over here, what we could do is we can filter out free transforms. And what we could do is standard transforms are already, you can say, installed. We can install caseful entities. I mean, I'm not saying go and install all the free transforms. Okay. But some of them, if I just want to show you, like you can install this case file entities. You can also install attack MISP. This is something we'll assist you in terms of hunting for IOCs and corporate investigation. It's by MITRE ATT&CK. It's based on MITRE ATT&CK framework. Okay. It's installed. This known as Social Links CE Community Edition. You can go over and install this also. At times, some of the free things also they ask you for signing into an account and all, such as VirusTotal API. You can get a free VirusTotal API. But it will, when you install the MySQL transform, it will tell you to give the API key over here, right? You can see Wayback Machine transform is already there. So whenever you scan a domain using Multigo, you'll be able to see the Wayback Machine domains already present. There are very limited choices for free, right? But similarly, if you go for some paid ones, Coefence Intelligence is there, right? Have I been pawned? Like, this is also a great transform, but again, it's a paid one. So, I mean, it requires API. MaxMind is there, PeopleMon is there, PIPL search engine is there. Right. So a lot of useful transforms are also available, but some of them are like they are paid. Okay. So have I been pawned is free. I didn't know. Let's go with this. Okay. Because we have I was only about to talk about this today itself. Have I been PWNED? Okay. So finish, that also is done. And what you could do is you can click on new graph over here. You'll find a lot of things to be added, whether you want to scan a device, whether you want to do something. Like you can see a lot of, there are a lot of options that you can get started, whether you want to search for a company, online group, religious group, political movement, banner, CVE, IPv4 address, whatever. You can just, you know, go in and search it for there. You can even go in for crime scene, right? So it's kind of an OSINT mapping tool, right? It's a favorite tool for OSINTers, right? And I can just get started with a domain. You can see an internet domain. And okay, so it's taking some time. Yeah, here I am. And I can add a domain over here saying that theactivists.in and right click and run. I mean, you can choose which transforms you want to run, but if you want to run all transforms, you have to click on all transforms. Over here, if you want to add some API keys, for example, if you want to do Whois XML and all, or you want to search in MISP, so you can see MISP server API key. So some of the, you can see things it's asking for APIs over here now. But if you don't have, you can just clearly go and run. Okay, so please accept the above disclaimer. Okay. Yeah. If you don't provide API keys, those scans won't be done. But all the, apart from that, whatever the scans are available, it will be done. Yeah, search MISP field, right? We'll see all the things will be presented in terms of graphical, like we can say division, like. And I think all the transforms are completed now. You can see you are getting Wayback Machine records easily. Right, you can even take a snapshots for it, and you can get all the details, like you are getting it, the location, the registrar, right, the DNS and all. You can further run more scans on it, right, if you find some relevance to it. What next I'll do is, I can go on to email address. I'll choose my own email. Okay, what I can do is directly run off have I been pwned. Now this have I been pwned service over here, it will tell us that whether an email was compromised in a data breach or not. This is very useful in every ways. In investigation ways, how it is useful, if I search in for my own specific email, you will find that my email has been breached. In one data breach, okay, Nitro, right? Similarly, if you see, and you know, recently there was a massive Facebook breach, okay, as an investigator, or you know, another form of OSINT you can do is, you can at times easily get the dumps of these data breaches. Easily, yeah, that's illegal. If you're using it for good purpose, then it's okay, but you can easily get the dumps of these data breaches. And what at times law enforcement agencies or they do is they download the dumps of those data breaches, and if they have the email of the suspect, they scan over here and get the credentials. Because in these breaches, there is a probability that, like, not there is a probability, the, like, the details are already listed out in plain text, okay, and the chance is that if that username and password is used on other social media sites, then what if the same password is used on other social media sites, right? If I just see, I have Facebook data, a bit of it. Okay, so I don't have for our own country. Yeah, I have over here. Okay, now what I could specifically do is, I can go and extract this up, and let me just try to extract this. Just give me a minute. Okay. Yeah, I'll just reshare the screen. And for example, this is an example data breach over here. Can again extract this specifically. And what this data breach contains, it contains a lot of details basically, right? This is something very lethal in terms of bad actor, but very useful in terms of investigation. So if I open this TXT file, now I don't know whether my TXT editor will be able to, oh see, it's loading, right? You see the mobile number, the Facebook URL, and I'm not sure whether passwords are included over here. I don't think so. But in, you know, if you find some cool data breaches, you'll find passwords in plain text. Okay. No, so mobile numbers have been compromised, but I'm not able to see the passwords in plain text. But in general, in these kind of data breaches, passwords are also, you can say, included as a plain text and can look up for the particular suspect in that particular breach. Okay, you see how many lines it's going, right? It's kind of, I don't know whether it's really working or something. Yeah, maybe the scan is going on. Okay, now what I can do is I can directly search in for my name, and I have second file also, so not sure it could be in any of the names, right? Because a lot of it was a massive data breach of like the Facebook, the most recent one I am saying, and this is a breach file for the recent one, in fact, right? So not sure. Let me wait, let us, you know, wait for the scan to complete a bit. Let me try to search my name. I think it's not able to search also because it's such large, or my name is not included. Could be in another breach then. Let me just try to go in and search in for user's name. Yeah, so probably the TXT editor is not able to handle the search. Probably that could be the problem. I don't have any TXT editor. But yeah, this is how, what I was just trying to say is you can easily find up the data breaches and look in over there for saying that if it's a suspect whose breach has been leaked, then like the best thing you can do is go in and search over there. Okay, that is what you can do. And have I been pwned helps us to do similar. For have I been pwned, you can just go into dehashed. Dehashed, initially when it was released, it used to even show the open text passwords directly, but now it doesn't. So it's doing some browser check. Let us wait. And here we go. We can input an email address and say such as. Now it's not 100% that all the you can say data breach reports or the data breach site show up the same results, but yeah, let me just quickly do this thing. Go in for email and choose my email. If you want to see the plain text passwords directly over here, you have to compulsorily, you can say, what's wrong? I guess I'm already logged in, right? So it's not able to show. Okay, just a minute. What I'll do is, yeah, you can see, have I been pawned? It is showing me that my have been, you can say, and nitro it was breached. Okay, just close this multi go, discard all. Am I logged in? I think so, I am. So let me just try to re-log in once. Why Google reCAPTCHA claims that I am a bot? Okay, what I'll do is I'll just quickly go up and create an account. Okay, so email is already being used. Give me a minute. Sorry, folks. I don't remember the password, right? So that's the only problem. Can just choose forward password. Submit and update. And yeah, I am logged in now. Now I can search in for email and let us check for my own email again. Yeah, so it's showing zero results found. Don't know why. Let me just go in and choose any other email. The email, any dummy email over here that I was using. Seven results have found, so request entry removal and all. And if I like go and expand, you need an active subscription to view the results, right? That is what it is showing. Initially, dhash used to show open text results and the passwords also, right? Which is 2 year old DB? Nitro or Facebook? FB. Yeah, could be. Because they say it's updated, but it depends. See, whenever you are downloading a data breach, see, I've downloaded it from Telegram, right? There are a lot of other black market forums and a lot of things where you could download these kind of dumps. But yeah, that is unreliable. That is something that we cannot do of it, right? No one can do anything of it. Like, yeah, if it's new, then it's a lottery, it's a jackpot. If it's not, but it's a kind of a hit and try method. It's completely hit and try method, right? At times you also get databases. In fact, like you see, there are a lot of databases which are actual legit databases, and they are something, you know, 5, 10, 15 GB. And just for a TXT file, okay? Like, yeah, like you can say 3, 5 GB just in a TXT file. And they are something you can download and check whether A lot of databases are leaked online where you can find the plain text passwords and all revealed easily. Okay, so that is very important in terms of investigation over here, right? Now, another important aspect for today we'll see in terms of OSINT is how do you view the LinkedIn profiles anonymously. Okay, So for example, I have LinkedIn, and you know, the LinkedIn functionality saying that I visit any profile, other person will get a message that profile has been viewed, correct? What I could do is, this is a profile that I want to look up. Let me just paste. No, it's not working. But anyhow, the only thing what exactly do we need is either we need a dummy account or something like that, or what I can do is see all results. Sorry. Let us look up for iUserve's profile. Copy link address. Let me just try and see. Yeah, see, this is over here. What I can do is I can go over here and I can got the LinkedIn profile ID, right? If I click over here, I'll be able to see iUserve's profile. I want to do this thing anonymously. There is a small, easy, simple trick for that. Okay. Now, there is there is a website by Google saying that mobile friendly viewer. Mobile-friendly test. You have to paste that URL over here, the LinkedIn URL, and click on test URL. On the next tab, you have to keep ready online HTML viewer. Code beautify. And you can see this page is mobile-friendly. You have to go to HTML, copy this entire HTML page, HTML code, I mean, paste over here, and you can choose run, and you can easily see a LinkedIn profile without notifying the profile. Okay. Now a general tools over here. There is website called as intellex.io. Open source intelligence and forensic tools. You will find on the left hand side a lot of tools available for general email domain. If I just go into email, okay, and a lot of tests it will go up and do. Right. If I similarly go to a domain, you will see who is information and everything it will help us to do. Same with IP and all, right? Okay, so what is Nitro? Okay, not sure. Yeah, so see what it's showing me about the Nitro data breach, right? But it is kind of hiding every step over there, right? Leaks. One of the leak. You have to sign up or log in to view redacted documents. Not sure whether I'll be able to see everything or not. Oh, here I think only email is included, not the plain text password. Yeah. So there is a particular data breach wherein it was like Nitro, right? So what this tool have done is it has found that it is this particular Nitro cloud.tsv is a file in which my things are also compromised, and it was found on line 5429, okay, of Y5343. What I could eventually do is there is a website called as pastebin. You can also look up for some leaks over here, right? Database leaks and all. Let me just go in and search. Or I can go it can, I mean, I'm just showing a general example. It, you can change the number of things as docs. Okay. Now this is something Nitro Coach. No. Nitro Leak, I can search. But what according to me, I'm finding that this tool is saying me that this text, this file was somewhere in which your data has been compromised, correct? So I can sign up, or I don't think so. The entire passwords and all will be shown, right? Not sure. You can go up and try. Similarly, there are a lot of other tools for IP, for Bitcoin, for image. Okay. What I can do is I can go on Google Images. Let me just give my own name over here. I can go up on any image. I can copy this particular URL from here, saying that copy image address and paste it. Select all again. Click on search. It will do the image reverse lookup and all. You can again check in for usernames over here. Person names. Okay. Over here. Phone number mainly doesn't work due to the fact that Indian phone numbers are not that easily accessible for OSINT. You can search in for files, hashes, hash, Google Analytics. It has some other tools also. Now, this is something magic file tool, which is very useful. Okay. What it does, basically, if you provide any file, it will extract the metadata, images and everything. So if there are images, it will automatically extract the metadata from those images and all those other things. So let me just try to do something with this, saying that I have a PDF. Let me just check. Let me just try to do this. It's a random file. The entire thing in a normal TXT format. See, download text. And there is a way, if there are images, you can even get the metadata for them.